What up, agents? Prime here. It's Tuesday again, and that means Vendor Reset Day. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching it. And it's Tuesday, so Vendor Reset Day. Let's see what the White House sells us. First thing is the named Golem backpack with 170k armor on there, the max cap, and of course perfectly wicked. It's a pretty decent roll, 4.4% critical hit chance already on there, and then roll that skill damage away for whatever your build needs, some status effect, or even some armor regeneration, whatever you like. Then over to the MP5, not that great if you ask me, just like the military 8 AKM. And the M1911, not that great as well. Maybe you can use it with that in-sync to proc your in-sync while on heroic for directives, because of course we don't have ammo if you use that pistolero, of course. Then we got the Badger backpack, not that great if you ask me. I'm not loving the rainbow roll on here. Just like with this Fenris vest with the protected reload on there, the weapon damage is pretty decent. You have some repair skills on there, but then the status effect should be something else. And in my opinion, you don't want protected reload on your vest. And I don't think this should be a talent at all at a vest. This should be a weapon talent. But yeah, that's just me. Over to the mods, guys. The first one, 10% critical hit damage. Then we got 4.8% damage reduction. Then we got 4.1% burn damage. And 4.1% skill haste for your sticky launcher. But that's pretty much it for the White House. Let's head over to the clan. And there we are, guys. The clan, 27 till 30. The White Death is the first thing we can buy. 137% headshot damage will always be on there. And the rest isn't that great. I'm not loving the fast hand as a talent on there. And at 3% rate of fire, no thank you. Over to the Nago holster, it has 12.1% weapon damage and 8.9% status effect. Could be decent, roll that status effect away for some critical hit chance or damage. Over to the Eclipse holster with 16.6k health on there. Yeah, I'm not a fan. Ongoing directive, 12.5% weapon damage and 16.3k health. Then we got another AKM, a little bit better than the one in the White House, but not that great. Tactical M1911, so the tactical version of the White House. You can buy it, but just leave it here in my opinion. Sokolov chest, 11.2% weapon damage, 10.3% skill haste, 8% headshot damage, and gunslinger. Not great. Not great at all. MG5, the infantry MG5, 11% LMG damage, 9% damage to target out of cover, and 9.3% stability, and close and personal on there. I wouldn't love close and personal on here, but the rest is pretty decent. The damage to target out of cover is nice, the LMG damage is pretty decent, and roll that stability away for whatever your build needs or whatever does the more damage. Damage to armor, for example. Over to the Araldi Holdings gloves with a max cap of 15% weapon damage, 8.5% hazard protection, and 7.3% explosive resistance. This could be a very nice one, especially if you're looking for this in a combination with hazard protection, because this hazard protection is only 1.5% away from the cap, and you already have that weapon damage high up there, or yeah, maxed out. Over to the knee pads of Gilligard, 124k armor, 5.1% critical hit chance, and 3.9k armor regeneration. Could be a nice one, but then, yeah, in my opinion, roll that armor a little bit higher, because the combination of armor regeneration and critical hit chance is pretty decent if you want it on a crit armor regen build, or, yeah, if you like to build that, of course. And then over to the Hannah U holster. It has 16.1k health on there, 8.7% hazard protection, but not that great. I don't know if you want that hazard protection on this Hannah U holster. If so, roll that health away for whatever you need. And then over to the mods, guys. The first one is 17.2% repair skills. Second one, 8.3% headshot damage. Third one, 8.3% headshot damage. Then we got the 6.5% healing for your mine. But let's head over to the campus. And there we are, guys, at the campus vendor. The first one is the named LMG Quiet Roar. 11% LMG damage, 8% damage to target out of cover, 8% stability, and of course, perfect overwhelmed on there. Then over to the M700 Tactical. Could be a nice buy, in my opinion. Roll that marksman rifle or that headshot damage a little bit higher, or roll that talent away, because this is the combination that you want for your M700 with that damage to armor on there. But then I don't know if you like that talent spike. Over to the custom L86. 10% LMG, 10% damage to target out of cover, and 4% damage to armor and ignited on there. Could be nice, but if you are going for an LMG, go for the MG5 in my opinion. Then over to the Vegetov mask, just leave this here, rainbow roll, not that great. Over to the China Light holster, 10.2% critical hit damage and 15.9% repair skill. You could use it both ways, roll that critical hit damage away for some skill damage, or roll that repair skills away for some skill damage, whatever your build requires. But this could be a nice holster. Over to the 16.2% repair skills, 5.8% skill haste for your cam launcher, 8.2% stim efficiency for your hive, 6.2% cone size for your pulse, and 4.2% duration for your shock traps. And that's it for the campus, guys. Let's head over to the theater. And there we are, guys, at the theater, and they love to sell us the firm handshake. There it is again. 10.2% weapon damage, of course, that 15% status effect on there, always on there, and then 6.8% explosive resistance. Not that great if you ask me. Tactical SASG, 14% shotgun damage, 7% damage to armor, and 7.3% stability, and pommel on there. Pommel could be nice, and then roll that stability away for something that you think is the best on this gun, because it already has a pretty decent damage to armor and a very high shotgun damage of 14%. ACRSS, 11% rifle damage, 12% critical hit damage, 7% health damage, and boomerang on there. Could be decent. Then we have the Fenris gloves, 8.4% weapon damage, max cap of armor regeneration, almost at 5k, and 5.7% skill damage. Not that great. It's very nice to have that max roll of armor regeneration on there, but all the other rolls are just too low. The weapon damage is way too low, and the skill damage, I don't know if you want it on these gloves. So in my opinion, don't buy them. Murakami knee pads, 4.5% critical hit chance and 9.9% critical hit damage. This could be nice if you want to combine this with some reds in your skill build. Over to the mods, 8.2% blind death resistance, 4.1% damage for your mine, 1% damage bonus per enemy for your shield, 5.8% damage for your firefly, and 5.5% duration for your decoy. But that's pretty much it. Let's head over to the DZs, guys. Let's see if they sell us something good. And there we are, guys, our first DZ. DZEs, the first thing is the Pinprick. 11% marksman rifle, 93% headshot, and 6% damage to target out of cover. And of course, perfect first blood on there. Could be nice if you're still looking for it and you cannot find it whatsoever. Over to the Model 700, 10% marksman rifle, 90% headshot, 8% critical hit damage, and reformation on there. Not that great. M249, 10% LMG damage, 9% damage to target out of cover, and 9.3% fire rate, and in sync on there. Again, this is not that great, especially not for their 101 DZ creds. Nago mask with 11.3% weapon damage and 4.7% critical hit chance already on there. This could be a very decent one if your build can hold that 4.7% critical hit chance. Definitely buy this and roll that weapon damage to that cap. Over to the future holster with 7.1% skill damage, could be nice. China Light mask, 8% headshot damage and 7.9% explosive resistance. Not that great on a mask of China Light, if you ask me. Over to the Sokolov, 10.5% weapon damage, 3.8k armor regeneration a second, and 16.1k health. Not that great roll. And then over to the mods, guys. 8.6% duration, we got 7.8% enchant duration for your cam launcher, we got 7.4% health for your hive, 8.7% radius for your pulse, and 5.8% shock radius for your shock traps. But just leave it here, guys. 73 DZ credits for mods, way too high. Let's head over to DZ West. And there we are, guys. DZ West. Everlasting Gaze is the first thing we can buy. 10% rifle damage, 11% critical hit damage, 8.5% accuracy, and of course, perfect preparation on there. Not that great, if you ask me. Double-barreled shotgun, not great. UC-15 could be nice, then roll that rifle damage a little bit higher. Eclipse Protocol, 8.4% hazard protection, could be nice if you're looking for it. Then we have the True Patriot, 122.4k armor and 8.5% status effect. Not that great. I would love to see that armor a little bit higher. Golem Gloves could be better, but it's pretty decent. The skill repair is pretty high up there, 17.1% and 8.5% hazard protection. So you could roll that armor a little bit higher. 5.11 knee pads, rainbow roll, not buying. 8.4% shock resistance, we got 5.9% healing, we got 4.3% holstered regeneration for your shield, and we got 1 max target and 6% duration for your decoy. Over to DZ South, guys. And there we are, guys. Last DZ, DZ South. First thing, 0 Fs, perfectly unbreakable, but not that great of a rolls. MP5N, just leave it here. The FAMAS, we can craft it, don't buy it. Officer M9, not that great if you ask me, just leave it here as well. Hardwired backpack with the max cap of 10% hazard protection. Could be nice if you're looking for it, but I don't think you're looking for a 10% hazard protection on a hardwired backpack. Then over to the Eclipse Protocol vest with, of course, that profileration on there and 8.6% hazard protection. If you're still looking for this vest from Eclipse Protocol, definitely pick it up. But yeah, open world, you can find it as well. And 109 DZ credits, not that great. Then over to the backpack from Sokolov, guys. 6% critical hit chance, 7.7% status effect, and 8.7% weapon damage and bloodsucker on there. Not that great if you ask me. Hanyu vest with skilled, 8.9% hazard protection, 3.7% armor regeneration, leave it here. 7.3% headshot damage, go to the White House, or my bad, go to the Clem vendor, you can buy it as well. Don't spend your DZ credits on this. 6.3% armor repair for your drone. We get 1 extra mortar armor, and we got 5% extra blast radius for your sticky launcher. But that's it for DC and the Dark Zones, guys. Let's see if New York can save this week. Probably not. First vendor of New York, Marco, will sell us a trash UMP. Over to the Surplus SVD, not that great as well. 6716 with the max cap of 17% critical hit damage on there, but the rest is just trash. M9A1, not that great, just leave it here. Big Horn backpack, 163k armor on there, could be nice, but the rest isn't that great. Knee pads of Aroldi, 11.5% weapon damage, 8.4% status effect, 16.8% repair skills, could be decent. The Jack Rabbit holster from Gilligard, rainbow roll. Over to the mods, 8.5% skill duration, 8.6% disrupt resistance. We got 4.1% burn damage for your turret, of course, and 5.7% damage for your firefly, and 6% duration for your decoy. Again, nothing to buy here. Let's head over to the last vendor. And there we are, guys. Last vendor at Roy, MP5, and decent rolls. Roll that 10% SMG damage a little bit higher, and you have a decent MP5 if you're looking for it. SRSA1. could be nice, the headshot damage almost max cap, but you have close and personal on there, and you don't want that on an MMR. SOCOM M1A could be nice, but I would love to see the rolls a little bit higher. If you want to buy this, then roll that critical hit damage, or damage your target out of cover, or even the talent, because rifle damage, critical hit damage, and damage to target out of cover are the things that you want on this M1A or this SOCOM. Over to the PX4 Storm, handgun, leave it here. Backpack from Murakami, 8.5% hazard protection, 6.9% explosive resistance, and shock and awe on there. Not that great of a combination. Richter and Kaiser gloves with 7.5% weapon handling, 9.7% skill haste, enough said. Badger Tough Mask, 112k armor, 10.4% critical hit damage, and 15.4% repair skills. Could be nice for a solo build, but then yeah, roll that armor a little bit higher, or whatever you like on this. I would roll that armor a little bit higher if you like that Badger Tough brand set. Over to the last mods, 4.3% critical hit chance, 8.5% shock resistance, 7.8% scan range for your drone, and 4 stinger charges, the max cap for your hive, so if you're still looking for it, pick it up. And then at last, that 5% blast radius for your sticky launcher. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the vendor reset. Hopefully Cassie will sell us some better things tomorrow. Of course we can find some max out attributes, but not on great gear guys. It's not great if you ask me, but that's it for today. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course the notification bell. Pure Prime out.